Yeah, we look nice, future looking real nice. We don't need to tell them twice.
Here comes the future.
For the third Liberty A-League round in a row, hello and welcome to McKellar Park in a battle of the original Uniteds. Canberra hosting Adelaide this afternoon. If Canberra can get the win today, they'll move equal on points with Melbourne Victory in fourth, setting up what is a must-watch final four games of the season. Last year's finalists Adelaide are not mathematically out of the finals race, but are as close to bottom place Phoenix as they are to the top four. A win today, in fact, would be their first in 2023. As the players get ready to start this one, we'll take a look at the Canberra United lineup today. They've made three changes to the team that beat the Wanderers 3-0 last time out. Goalkeeper Chloe Lincoln and youngster Sasha Grover out of the squad. They're currently travelling to Bishkek to help the young Matildas qualify for the Under 20 Asia Cup. That means that Keely Richards starts in goal and Emma Ilioski replaces Sasha Grove. Ellie Brush also drops out of the squad injured. She's replaced at centre-back by the Canadian Kennedy Faulkner. Meanwhile, for the visiting Adelaide United, they've made one change to the side that drew with Melbourne Victory last week. Striker Chelsea Dorber has been recalled by parent club Chicago Red Stars in the NWSL. So Katie Bowler makes her first start for the Reds. Striker Amelia Murray and backup goalkeeper Grace Wilson also off with the young Matildas. So Jenna Farrow comes onto the bench. Also appearances on the bench for new late signings, the Dane Hannah Holgerson and youngster Aaron Kontoutsikos. Canberra United getting ready for the game today, completing their final warm-ups, and there is Keely Richards. Her third appearance of the season for the goalkeeper, and don't be fooled by her backup status. She is a quality goalkeeper, someone who was first choice before a season-ending injury in February last year gave young Chloe Lincoln the opportunity to take the gloves. And a memorable moment for the 20-year-old Katie Bowler, making her first start after 8 substitute appearances for the Reds this season. She played for Adelaide City in the South Australian NPL and has big shoes to fill today. Well, it wasn't so long ago that Canberra head coach Negos Popovic was under fire after consecutive 5-goal defeats, but the women in green have managed to turn it around with 3 straight victories, and his message has remained consistent throughout, that the potential in his young squad just needed more time to grow. Well, the referees today on your screen is fourth official Georgia Ghirardello. Isabella Libri will be the center official, assisted by Delphina Demoski and Amber Morris. Last year's coach of the season, Adrian Stenta, he's had plenty to think about this time around, and he's admitted that this season hasn't quite turned out the way that he and his team would have liked. But nonetheless, there is plenty of talent in that squad. If they can find the route to gold that has been so difficult this season, they can still defeat anyone in the competition. All set to go on a glorious day in Canberra. It'll be Michelle Heyman standing over the ball. Grace Jarlay, the New Zealand international, readying herself on the wing. And for Canberra United, if they can make it 4 wins in a row today, they know that they are in a real race for the top four. That woman, Michelle Heyman, well, when she scores this season for Canberra, well, they simply win. And it is her who gets us underway in Canberra. A lot at stake for both teams today. Adelaide looking to keep their season alive, and Canberra looking to make it four wins from the last four. Will be Canberra looking to keep early possession on that far side. Flannery finding herself in some space. Although the offside flag, much to her dismay, rules the attack out. And Adelaide United, through Jenna McCormick, will have an opportunity to play the ball out from the back. One of Adelaide's new signings today, Hannah Holgersen, actually played in Denmark for AGF with Jenna McCormick, so no doubt the connection there. It is Canberra streaming forward. Good take from Annalie Grove in goals for Adelaide. It's been good this season, Grove, somewhat of a breakout season for her. Spent the 2019-20 season at Canberra, in fact, but didn't make an appearance in that season. No doubt will be familiar with many of the players that she's coming up against today. And an interception in midfield here, streaming forward is Faulkner. Intercepted. We normally see her at centre back, Kennedy Faulkner, an adventurous run from her. It does look like that is where she is taking her position today, in place of the experienced Ellie Brush. Maybe early signs of the danger that she can possess in Canberra, always possessing a threat on the counter-attack. Pacey forwards up front. Ma also playing in the back today. Better known for her midfield exploits, but can playmake from the back. And it's Milivojevic now in some space. Well cut out by Haywood. And McCormick will distribute the ball back to her. Intercepted though, high up the pitch. Laura Hughes will look to launch the ball into the box. At that target, Heyman, but it's Milivojevic who's had a touch in the box and has been brought down. And the referee has awarded a penalty early on in this game. And it's Vesna Milivojevic who has won the penalty for Canberra. They'll have an early opportunity to take the lead. As we see on the replay, Heyman managed to squeeze the ball to Milivojevic, and I think it was McCormick who was at fault. Some heavy contact on Milivojevic. And Canberra with an opportunity from the spot. It'll be Grace Maher to take for Canberra. Three goals already this season. She has Annalie Grove to beat. Grace Maher to take and in. Canberra United take the early lead at home. And as things stand, they are equal on points with fourth. This late charge to the finals has taken another step. We see a replay of that penalty, just wonderfully put away. You don't expect anything less from Grace Maher. Annalie Grove dove the right way, but was just unable to stop what was a perfectly placed penalty. Adelaide now, they'll be desperate to get back into this. Oh, Canberra, they have a habit of scoring early. Nearly 50% of their goals this season have come in the first 30 minutes of games. And they've been very successful when scoring early as well. Now Adelaide with a mountain to climb, conceding so early. Faulkner does well, although intercepted by Dylan Holmes. She can be so dangerous from this distance. Holmes, well cleared eventually, but not before Holmes made it past two or three defenders. Adelaide, they've certainly got the players to make life difficult for any team. But it's just converting. They've scored the lowest amount of goals in the league so far, Adelaide, with only 9 for the season in the 13 games that they've played. And that has been their kryptonite and the problem for coach Adrian Stenter to solve. And they scored 2 last week. Certainly showed signs of life in that game. But without Chelsea Dorber, who scored 4 of those 9 goals, it's certainly a much more difficult task for them. Canberra, well, they've shown that when they score one, they can score more, being goal-friendly for them this season. Heyman chasing down that one. Ball out for an Adelaide throw. It is remarkable for Canberra that they had those consecutive 5-0 defeats against Wellington Phoenix and also against Western United and still have a goal difference of 0, so it shows that despite those heavy defeats, they've inflicted similar scorelines on other teams as well. Bit like a box of chocolates, Canberra. You don't quite know what you're going to get, but you know it will entertain, and early signs in this game that they are certainly on the entertaining side of that. Misha Westland scored for Adelaide last week, so she'll be hoping to be an integral part of their potential fight back today. Grace Maher does well up to Milivojevic. All the way back, Heyman applying the pressure, Michelle Heyman. The ball does manage to get back to Grove. Ushka Waldus. The Dutchwoman passes to McCormick. Long ball now searching for the feet of Emily Hodgson, finds her. Emily Hodgson, what can she do? Passes it back to Bowler. Bowler being put under pressure by Hayley Taylor-Young, who does well, but Adelaide will have the first corner of the game. Taylor Young didn't start the season, was injured to begin, but has certainly made an impact since she's started. But now Hodgson, shot from distance, cleared away, in a bit of danger, calls forehand ball from the Adelaide players, but it is scrambled away in the end by Canberra. Oh, it's dangerous for a moment, streaming forward again here at Adelaide. Westlands trying to force the issue. Keely Richards will have the ball for a goal kick as we see, looks like a rehearsed corner routine there from Adelaide. And Hodgson just not able to get the power required for that to really challenge Keely Richards in goal. Interestingly, in the first 10 minutes, Adelaide, they've had 73% of possession, so it's not for lack of having the ball. So here we go again, Canberra on the counter, blocked away. There's the danger, and it was that woman, Michelle Heyman, the all-time leading goal scorer in this competition, who was lurking in the box. You just cannot relax when that woman is anywhere near the penalty area. Heavy challenge from Dylan Holmes on Laura Hughes, and the team in green win themselves a foul. She'll opt to play it back to Faulkner. Grace Maher launch it long, and Nikki Flannery in some space. Can she find option? She cuts it back, a shot, deflection, and in! Was the final touch off Michelle Heyman? It was! Her 80th goal for Canberra United. Her 92nd in the A-League women. She simply cannot be stopped. Age will not weary her. And it is another goal for the talisman of this league. There was just so much space on that side for Flannery. Milivojevic had the shot, and Heyman. That is such a poacher's goal from Michelle Heyman, just finding herself in the right area to knock that home. Absolutely nothing that Annalie Grove could do. And Canberra, two goals to the good early in this contest. And while it was mentioned earlier that Canberra United now equal on points with Melbourne Victory, but if they can win today by 5 goals, which may seem far-fetched, but given their fast start, maybe not impossible, they will actually sneak in to that fourth spot. And given that Melbourne Victory have the bye this week, that could be where they finish this round of fixtures. So that will no doubt be in the sights of Negos Popovic and his team. Of course, they played an important role last season in the makeup of the finals. They played Melbourne Victory on the last game of the season, and whilst indirectly, if they had beaten them, Victory wouldn't have made the top four last season. And well, Victory of course went on to become champions and defeat Adelaide United in that first round of finals. But this season, rather than indirectly influencing results, Canberra looked to be in a good position to take control of the fate of the finals themselves. Faulkner being put under some pressure and manages a nice little turn to get it away. And Canberra, you can see that they're very difficult to stop, playing very direct. And Adelaide not having the answers at the moment. It's Milivojevic again in some space. Doesn't quite manage to reel that one in. Might feel a little bit gypped for that goal, of course. It looks like it may have been going in anyway without that Heyman touch. I don't think she'd be too unhappy for the team getting a goal on the board. Jale attempting a 1-2, but the ball will go out for a goal kick. Having another look at that. Well, maybe Grove did have it covered if Heyman hadn't have been there, to be fair. So maybe Milivojevic can't have too many complaints about the goal being taken from her. Ma, good tackle, gets the ball to Hughes. Hughes looks up, crosses in for Heyman. Waldis with a vital intervention to concede the corner. And that again is just an example. Adelaide United really not at the races at the moment, just being carved open by these direct balls from Canberra. Really not able to get any kind of foothold on this game as of yet. Emma, Milivojevic, one arm up. Delivers the corner, front post, cleared away. Back in, but cleared again. Although Laura Hughes now on the edge of the area, poked through. Emily Grove collects. A reminder, of course, this Adelaide United side finished third last season and started this season very brightly as well, with 1-0 victories, including over Sydney FC in round one. And unfortunately for them, as the season's gone on, it's unraveled a little bit. And if they're not careful here, they may find themselves in the end of a big scoreline. Canberra certainly looking up for the fight in front of their home fans today. Oh, neat little chip over the top. Oh, cut out. Industrious challenge by captain Isabel Hodgson on Grace Maher, and perhaps that shows her frustration with the proceedings in the first 16 and a half minutes. Faulkner long, looking for Flannery. You can't control it. A wry smile at her bench, perhaps paid practice that at training. Very difficult one to control, of course. Well, for a moment, looks like Milivojevic may have been away, but a foul conceded on Holmes. It'll be Walders looking to get things underway quickly, but nothing doing. Sasaki comes in and shows for the ball. Neat little wall pass. Ball up the pitch and it finds Barbieri, but denied by the offside flag. So for a moment it looked like Barbieri might be in some space. Hasn't really had too much opportunity on the ball so far. Barbieri can be quite dangerous when she does, but Adelaide not able to enact any sort of effective possession at the moment. Adelaide lifting it forward, and it is Barbieri with the ball at her feet and in some space, but Ma does very, very well to hold her up, and Keely Richards able to collect. Grace Maher, normally a midfielder, really known for her creative output, but she's done really well on that occasion to hold up play, and indeed Canberra's winning run coinciding with that change. Ball over the top now, and a shot, and it's in! Wonderful from Adelaide, and it's Katie Bowler with her first A-League women's goal in her first start, and there is life in this game yet. That is a lovely ball over the top, and what a chip from Katie Bowler. A superb ball from Misha Westland, the outside of her left boot. Katie Bowler, take a bow. And that will end up on the highlight reel this week. Jale driving into the box. Grace Jale still going now. Jale, shot blocked. Adelaide scrambled it away. Well, suddenly this game has opened up end-to-end stuff. here at McKellar Park. Hughes now. Blocked away in Adelaide. An opportunity of their own. Well, Katie Bowler, what a way to mark your first start in this competition. Really good stuff from the 20-year-old. And puts Adelaide back in this game, in this contest. So having a look at this goal again, and look how she changes the foot that she's trying to shoot from. Fainted almost with her right, went with her left, and managed to chip it over the goalkeeper with her left. It's simply magnificent from the 20-year-old. And it's the sort of goal that might, just might, spark her team here. Only the 10th goal that Adelaide United have scored this season. And here she goes again, Bowler, in some space, looking for options in the middle. Driving, crossing herself, Hughes just about clears. Only as far as Sasaki. Now back out wide, Paige Haywood. Cross initially blocked, but Haywood still on the ball. Laura Hughes did well. It'll be an Adelaide corner. Nanako Sasaki, the player with the opportunity to deliver the corner now for Adelaide. Players crowding in the box, and we've seen this a lot this season. The corner tactics be very tight to the keeper. Sasaki, she'll swing it in on the penalty area. McCormick with a free header over the crossbar. She should have hit the target there, Jenna McCormick, and she knows it. We'll see a replay of this opportunity. Really nice delivery from Sasaki. McCormick completely unmarked. Right on the penalty spot. Just couldn't keep her header down. Adelaide, though, they come again. Dylan Holmes fouled. He has fouled an awful lot like that, Dylan Holmes. Really classy player on the ball. Sasaki and Barbieri standing over it. Looks like a corner, a free kick routine rather, again from Adelaide. Only that time, delivery not meeting whatever conniving plan that they had in mind. Keely Richards will take the goal kick. Ball in. Holly Murray getting involved, but Adelaide come out with it. Holmes ball through. Oh, and that was tight. Grace Ma leaving it for her goalkeeper. And Katie Bowler almost got a foot on it. Now Hayley Taylor Young down the wing, slips. Adelaide win the throw. They've got numbers forward, but that touch unfortunately didn't allow for the counter to continue. They'll start again, Adelaide, through Sasaki, out wide, all the way to Haywood, ball in, and danger signs again for Canberra. Keely Richards doing well to hold on. Barbieri was lurking. Well, we'll take a look again at these opportunities for Adelaide. Again, Keely Richards doing well to come out and smother that one. And the cross in, not quite meeting Barbieri at the front post. 28-year-old Keely Richards having a busy time in goal in the last 10 minutes or so. Her 20th A-League women's appearance today, all for Canberra. Adelaide come again, ball into the box, back post, Faulkner. Very necessary touch from the Canadian, because there were players at the back post ready to tap that ball home. A crucial intervention. Coming into the starting lineup in place of Ellie Brush today. And that was vital to keep her team in the lead. Short corner from Adelaide. Sasaki all the way out. We saw this before. Emily Hodgson this time opts to go back out, and all danger areas again for Canberra. Danger not over. Adelaide ball still pinging around the box. Jale clears it away, and Canberra will have the free kick in the end. But every time at the moment, Adelaide are getting the ball up that side of the pitch, has looked dangerous. And well, what a thing a goal can do for a team's confidence. Feels like a game of two halves, but it's only been 27 minutes. Michelle Heyman now on the ball, looking to beat McCormick, but McCormick uses her strength to bundle her off the ball. Driving forward is Murray. Taylor Young, Murray. Ball in by Murray, and Heyman got a foot on it, but McCormick has used her strength again and appeals for a penalty not given by referee Isabella Libri. Well, Heyman believes that she's fouled here. A nice ball from Murray. Heyman got a foot on it initially, and well, McCormick will argue she's just stood up to her there. And when you compare the contacts on the first penalty, I'm not so sure. And well, we've seen a yellow card produced back live, and a penalty for Adelaide United. Well, we can see Adelaide sprung the counter-attack straight away, and it was Dylan Holmes. There's a free kick just outside the box, and a yellow card for a professional foul. Barbieri standing over it. Well, confusion at one end and opportunity at the other. Mindy Barbieri standing over this free kick. She unleashes just over the crossbar. Well, this is breathless stuff at MacKellar Park at the moment. You do not want to miss a minute of this action. Grace Maher out wide. Jale. Long diagonal, looking for Flannery. Wonderful touch from Nikki Flannery. She'll launch it into the back post. Heyman! Michelle Heyman does it again! A diving header from Michelle Heyman restores Canberra's two-goal advantage. And that is what Canberra United can do. A wonderful long diagonal. Nikki Flannery just put it on a platter for Heyman. She goes equal in the Golden Boot standings. That is her 11th goal of the season at 34 years of age. This woman does not stop. And it's 3-1 to Canberra, all within 30 minutes. We see the return of that long diagonal that Adelaide have really struggled against today. But what a wonderful ball from Nikki Flannery. Firstly, the touch, and then the cross in. Right on a platter for Heyman. And you love to see a diving header like that in the Liberty A-League. We've been treated to some fantastic goals today. It's one of those goal scorers, Katie Bowler, who wins a free kick for Adelaide in a dangerous position. Hayley Taylor-Young, the culprit on that occasion. Ball in now for Adelaide. Back post header, and it's a goal! Another goal in this game! Can you believe it? It's Mariska Walvis. The Dutch woman pulls it back once more for Adelaide.
Number 19,
unbelievable scenes at McKellar Park. Walvis able to turn her body so effectively in that situation and steer the ball into the back corner. Unbelievable scenes in this first half. It is 3-2 to Canberra United. And we still have over 10 minutes of the first half to play. Well, every Melbourne Victory fan and player watching this game just cheered that goal. Adelaide back into this game again, but it is Canberra who are on the charge. Jale now. Jale looking for an opportunity to shoot, doesn't find one. Plays it back to Taylor-Young, who shank across in, cleared. And as far as Jale, back to Taylor-Young. And back to Ma. We know what she can do from distance, Grace Ma. Well, even for her, that was maybe a little bit ambitious, but given what this game has showed us so far, wouldn't have been surprised if that had found its way in. Simply remarkable. Fans in Canberra being treated to an absolute spectacle today. Taylor-Young up the line. Heyman wins the header and gives it straight back to Walvis. McCormick. Laura Hughes applying the pressure. Flannery as well. Kennedy Fork now nips in ahead of Holmes. Jale was looking for Heyman but intercepted. Faulkner pressure on her from Barbieri. Who does well. Now Adelaide streaming forward, but Milivojevic finding Heyman. Is she onside? No, flag up for Michelle Heyman. It did look maybe a little bit incredulous. You can see the young fans doing, I think, the NRL third umpire arm movement. They thought that there should be a review, but I think the assistant referee in the best position to make that call. We'll see a replay of that offside call. And yes, it does look from that angle like she was offside. We'll have to trust the assistant's call with that one. Marta Taylor-Young tried to keep it in, but it will be an Adelaide throw. Hodgson, Sasaki. Adelaide driving for Jale, intercepts. Her straight line speed is among the best in this league. And speaking of speed, Michelle Heyman now on his far side looking for options. Cross is blocked. Canberra with another opportunity from a corner. It's the numbers on Michelle Heyman's career, just extraordinary. 81 goals for Canberra United, 93 in total. Well, the 100 seemed far-fetched at the beginning of the season, but with four games to go after this one, she keeps up this goal scoring. There is a chance she could become the first woman to score 100 goals in the Liberty A-League. Corner in now for Canberra, back post Jale, headers it back in, Faulkner. Still on here for Canberra, cleared away, Taylor-Young, heavy touch. Still going, Taylor-Young, squares it, Jale, edge of the area, looking for a shot, can't find one. Back out to Ma. Ma dinks it back in, Heyman now in a race but unable to reel it in. And it'll be another corner for Canberra from the other side this time. Goal scoring threats from absolutely everywhere in this game. It'll be Grace Maher to take Canberra's fifth corner of the game so far. Ball delivered in on the penalty spot, cleared away, although on the follow-up, Milivojevic couldn't control the volley. You can see the frustration in her face, but to be fair, it would have been remarkable had she managed to control that ball. Sasaki, well, she was under some pressure and the ball has been turned over. Flannery deflected. Canberra will have another corner. They're playing with such an intense press at the moment, Canberra. Very difficult for Adelaide to play through. You can see there another look at that attempt. Milivojevic. She was looking at the top corner of the goals, but those ones notoriously difficult to control. Takes a remarkable amount of skill to get over that ball. Ah, ball in once more, right on the penalty spot again, and Jale, well, she got a touch on it, never under control. And a touch to the cheek, perhaps indicating where she got that touch. And Adelaide now, well, the danger's not over because they have to play it out from the back here. So you see a replay of that in picture, and Grove decides this time just to kick for distance. Now, bit of a 2v2, Richards out. She made the right decision that time, although an audacious attempt from distance. Didn't quite have the legs on it. Richards was well out of her box. And it was well worth an attempt. You could see the heart-in-mouth moment from the Canberra defence. So we see a replay of this. Keely Richards did meet the ball, but the clearance didn't have the distance required and just hit it straight back to an Adelaide player. Jarle now, long throw, Milivojevic chasing it down. Walders bundled over Milivojevic, cross back post! Flannery couldn't get the header under control. Grove was beaten. And Nikki Flannery almost with Canberra's fourth. And you have to say, she'll be kicking herself for that one. She probably should have hit the target. Nice cross from Milivojevic. The goalkeeper beaten and a golden opportunity passed up. But here we go again up the other end. And then Holly Murray does really well, the Victorian. Adelaide streaming forward. Hodgson against Taylor Young. Murray gets a foot in and Taylor Young clears. And only as far as Sasaki. Sasaki again keeping it alive for Adelaide. And this time the ball is cleared. You can see the frantic nature of this game. 10 shots for Canberra, 6 for Adelaide. And really the first 15 minutes, Adelaide not really at the races, but then that wonderful goal to Katie Bowler brought them alive. And it's been end-to-end stuff since then. Adelaide driving forward, Hodgson beats Jarle. Hodgson, ball in, cleared by Faulkner. Sasaki, out wide to Bowler. And Taylor Young, it does well to get a foot in. And there you go again, Bowler. Left-footed cross in, cleared by Ma. Haywood, uncontrolled. Bit of football tennis at the moment. The ball just trying to be cleared by any means. Oh, wonderful touch again. She's really having a game to remember today, Bowler. It's back to Hodgson. Walders. Heyman putting Adelaide under some pressure here. And forces the errant clearance from Grove. It gives Canberra another push for another goal in the dying moments of this half. What has been a remarkable half of football. Heyman, Murray. Intercepted. Does well, Jarle. Heyman. And almost finding Flannery. But a crucial interception from Isabel Hodgson. Marta Milivojevic. Out wide again to Laura Hughes. Nikki Flannery. And Milivojevic tries for the 1-2. Doesn't quite get there. Ilioski in left back today. The absence of Sasha Grove with the young Matildas requiring a little bit of a reshuffle of that back line for Canberra, but she stepped up to the role with aplomb. Ball from Bowler. Finds a teammate. And an errant pass relieves the pressure. Well, this remarkable half could have some more goals in it. 4 minutes of additional time. before players and fans alike can catch their breath. Still time for either side to make something happen in this half. Ball over the top, cleared, although a shot and oh, just wide. It was Barbieri on her left. A golden opportunity for Adelaide to equalise before half time. And it's gone begging. Just couldn't control the ball on her left foot there, Barbieri. I think Richards was unsighted. But thankfully, from her point of view, the ball just trickling past her post. Now Milivojevic, still going Milivojevic, and an industrial challenge from Sasaki. No foul given from the referee. She certainly went in with some force. The play has continued. We'll have a look at this challenge again from Sasaki. The referee saw nothing in it. The play was allowed to continue. It's certainly a forceful challenge. A little bit of a stoppage here as the referee had a word to Jenna McCormick, and you could see Georgia Ghirardello speaking to Adrian Stenter as well about whatever was going on there. Maybe just a little bit of a clarification around girl kicks, perhaps. Now ball over the top, Hodgson. Jale does well. Still 2 minutes of stoppage time left in this half. Sasaki, attempted backfield, intercepted by Milivojevic. She's on the ball now. Oh, and Warwick Hughes and Michelle Heyman both in so much space. Hughes saved from Annalie Grove. A golden opportunity to extend their lead before halftime, although it's not over. Heyman with a ball in, and Hughes unable to keep her feet. Well, I don't think she expected that opportunity. The Red Sea parted in front of her. The Adelaide defense melted away. But she just was unable to convert. And Grove did really well, standing up as long as she could. Now Heyman now driving forward. Can't find Hughes. Adelaide perhaps one last chance of their own. Streaming forward, bowler intercepted. Holly Murray does well to get it out wide. Heyman is lurking. Flannery on the ball. New tackle decisively made. Faulkner will be there to cut off the chance for Adelaide. Referees looking at their watch. And that is half time. A remarkable half of football at McKellar Park. You will struggle to find a better half of football than that this season. Canberra United find themselves one goal to the good. It's Canberra United 3, Adelaide United 2. Well, we'll have a look at the stats. It was 2-0 Canberra within 12 minutes. And then Adelaide, that remarkable goal from Katie Bowler, got them back into the contest. Michelle Heyman with her second to make it 3-1, and then Mariska Walders almost immediately hitting back. Pretty even game. You can see Canberra just with their noses in front on the stats and also where it matters. Join us after the break. Don't go anywhere. It's Canberra United 3, Adelaide United 2. To McKellar Park in Canberra, where, well, if you missed the first half, you missed a remarkable half of football. Canberra United lead Adelaide 3-2. It means that they're even with Melbourne Victory in fourth place as things stand, but still plenty of action to come in this game. We'll have a look back through the goals. It started off a penalty to Grace Maher that was won by Milivojevic. And then not long after, this goal from Michelle Heyman. But then Adelaide, they hit back. And it was Katie Bowler, her first goal in the A-League Women on her first start. Canberra, not to be denied, they hit back once more. Nice touch from Flannery. Michelle Heyman, a diving header into the back of the net. But Adelaide will not lie down, and it was Mariska Walbus, the centre back, who headed home from a free kick. Well, at half time, Canberra United have made one substitute. Cheng Shu Wu, the Chinese international, returns. She replaces Holly Murray in midfield. So slightly different players. We'll have to see how that plays out for Canberra in this second half. And we are underway. Adelaide United, get us started. Going from left to right on your screen in this second half. And Wu straight into the action. Dylan Holmes putting pressure on that back line. A reminder, this game will have the utmost importance on the finals race as it stands. Canberra equal on points with Melbourne Victory in fourth. Adelaide still searching for their first win in 2023. They will attempt to play out from the back now. Dylan Holmes busy as always. In midfield, the one cap Matilda. She's ever present in this side. Misha Westland's trying to squeeze through, but blocked away from this Canberra backline. And now we see Canberra on the charge. Nikki Flannery in some space. Can she find options in the middle? She drives back post, but Wu not able to reach the ball. And it is cleared away for a throw. Wu will offer a little bit more dynamism, perhaps, than Holly Murray. Murray, more of a defensive-minded kind of player who has done a superb job for Canberra in previous three starts in breaking up the play. But Wu just adds even more creativity to this side. Perhaps coach Nagos Popovic thinking that Canberra will need more goals to secure the 3 points in this one. And why not with the game the way that it's gone? Flannery ball in, looking for Heyman. Grove, well, the grab wasn't clean to begin with, but she has managed to gather the ball in the end. And Heyman always lurking, her two goals today, putting her equal top of the golden boot ladder with Hannah Keane of Western United. 11 goals for the season. Age 34, just remarkable. Of course, it was only a few seasons ago where she had a year off, and I think A-League Women's fans feared that we wouldn't see her in the league again, but here she is, and still tearing up the record books. Hodgson with the throw. Still on it again here, Hodgson. Sasaki now in some space against Faulkner. Beats Faulkner, Sasaki. And Keely Richards with a vital intervention, clinging on to the ball. For all that there has been plenty of goals today, the keepers, for the most part, have been pretty good. Not too much that could have been done about the goals that have been scored. Keely Richards, certainly a very handy player to have as backup to Chloe Lincoln, who is, of course, off with the young Matildas for under 20 Asia Cup qualifying, along with teammate Sasha Grove. And for Adelaide, their backup keeper, Grace Wilson, as well as attacker Aminia Murray, is over there as well. I'm sure keenly watching these games from Bishkek. And of course, we wish them the best of luck in their qualifying. Taylor Young looking for Heyman. Heyman almost getting away from one, but assistant referee says ball did go out. Ball in good fun from assistant Amber Morris as Heyman attempts to put the pressure on, but McCormick running away with it. Wu, pressure now, and wins the ball back, does Wu. And McCormick forced to play it back to her goalkeeper, Grove. And ball up the line, Jale tracking back. Ball dinked into the penalty area. Shouts for handball against Ilioski. Keely Richards forced to come out and claim. Really vital piece of skill from the goalkeeper on that occasion. So we see the replay. Ilioski, well, her hand was by her side in a natural position, so it is hard to argue for a handball, but certainly got her body positioning not quite right as a defender. There is certainly more action in this game yet. And Sasaki does well to Haywood. Ball being chased down by Holmes, but Grace Maher does well. Flannery back out, and well, Canberra player Hughes was collected in the process, but let's look at a replay of that handball shout. Well, there can be an argument to be made. I'm sure Adelaide fans will think that her arm was away from her body. We'll be getting the rulers out. But I think a fair enough call from referee Isabella Libri. Sasaki now blocked by Faulkner. They'll come again here, Adelaide. Ball skewed out wide. A chase on. Flannery wins. And the clearance, well, went very high. Not quite as much distance as I'm sure she would have liked. And captain Isabel Hodgson with the throw in. Adelaide now chasing into the box. Westland shot blocked, and well, I'll have another corner. Oh, Adelaide will prepare to take this corner, and interestingly, according to the XG, which different people will take different stock in, and Sasaki delivers the ball and cleared by Jale, but he's going to ground. Sasaki coming away with that. We'll get back to that XG stat as the ball delivered into the box. Richards fumbles, but a foul given for contact on the keeper. She looks in maybe a little bit of strife here, Keely Richards, maybe just reeling from that contact. Well, she does get to her feet. You'll see the replay of this ball from Sasaki. And yeah, there was significant contact on Richards from Waldis. She's all smiles, so that's good to see. A bit of pressure being applied now to Canberra. Adelaide on the charge again. Ball through. Haywood squares it. Westland, short blocked. Still going here, Adelaide. And cleared away. You simply cannot take your eyes off this action. Any minute, opportunities are being created. And on that occasion, that shot from last week's goal scorer, Misha Westland, was blocked away. Well, I'll get back to that XG stat now. Before those current opportunities, Adelaide United only with an XG of 0.75 for their two goals, and Canberra, by contrast, an XG of 3.72. Now, XG is a calculation of how likely you are to score from any certain situation, so it's not the perfect indicator of how a game is going, but it is informative, and it is a fascinating insight into this game. Adelaide really making the most of their opportunities. Canberra perhaps having the better of the opportunities, and they are, of course, still in the lead. But maybe on another day, could have had four or even five goals. But Adelaide streaming forward, ball through, controlled by Haywood, and a shot on her left, always rising. And certainly worth an effort from Haywood. Richards was backtracking in goals. And just over the crossbar. We'll see this opportunity again, almost a carbon copy of the shot that was blocked earlier. This time it was Haywood who wound up and got the shot away. It's not quite enough dip on her effort. Sasaki, ball over the top. Ma does really well in battle with Haywood to clear it out for a corner. This week, of course, A-League's All Access returns to the Liberty A-League, and it's Grace Ma, that woman in green, who is the focus. Well, a shot from distance here, securely in the breadbasket of Keely Richards. Heyman. Reverse ball through Jale now in space. Got Flannery on her inside. Jale, she'll go herself here. Jale, shot blocked. We'll go out for a corner. New Zealand's international, two goals so far this season. Hasn't maybe been as prolific this season as she was at the Phoenix last, but certainly a vital role to play as we see the replay of the last two attempts. Keely Richards able to grab the first, and McCormick blocking Charlie's effort. Grace Ma from the set piece. Ball in back post, Faulkner. Got some contact. Not enough to challenge Grove. And Grove will play it short. Adelaide looking to play out from the back today. And maybe that's been really one of the differences between the two sides today. Adelaide maybe looking to keep possession a little bit more. Ludmila Vojvic almost on the end of that. And that shows the dangers in this league of playing out from the back. Yes, we all enjoy possession football, but Canberra's much more direct approach has so far been the more effective. Wu, lovely turn from the Chinese international. Heyman over the top. Flannery can't quite turn, is driven to the corner by Isabel Hodgson, and it will be a goal kick to Adelaide. You can see this piece of skill again from Wu, completely selling Sasaki up the river there. Created an opportunity for her side. And that's probably the difference between her and the player that she's been substituted on for, Holly Murray. Murray's been very effective, but just in a different role. Wu will be able to create a little bit more for Canberra. Faulkner with a foot in. Hughes. Grace Ma. Taylor Young. Up the line. Wu trying to reel it in against Walders. Walders gets the block in. Started in the final of last year's Asian Cup, did Wu, where China were ultimately successful against South Korea. A really wonderful moment for her. So on the ball again, blocked away. And Canberra will have another corner. It was actually compatriot Zhao Yuyi who scored the winning goal in that game. She played for Adelaide this season but has since returned to China. Milivojevic, short corner. Ball in now, almost reached by Wu. Wu will keep the opportunity alive. And skewed out for Jale, who finds Hughes. Hughes looking for Milivojevic. Ball deflected. Sasaki on the ball. And now Adelaide with numbers forward. Who can she find? Finds Haywood. And the touch gets away from her. Although Sasaki keeps the possession alive for the Reds. Long ball forward. And Keely Richards tells everyone to have a breather, have a break, a calm down, and will gratefully gather the ball. Jale, Wu. Hughes again put under some pressure. And Richards says enough of that, launches it long. A little bit messy in the midfield for both sides at the moment. Westland almost away. It's a slight errant touch. Hodgson. Barbieri does well to keep possession. Holmes. Out wide. Looking for the wall pass. Bowler. Ball in. And it'll be out for a goal kick. It's fantastic to see both captains today, wearing those Pride Progress captain's armbands. As Adelaide continue to press, a little foul given on Wu. And the message of those armbands is inclusion for all. There's certainly no love lost between these two sides today. Groups of competitors really going at it today at Makilla. Ilioski does really well to win the ball off Haywood. Haywood chasing down Jale, who beats one. Isn't quite able to get past Sasaki. Hughes will pick the ball up to Faulkner. Faulkner, we've seen her a few times go on a few adventures from centre back Kennedy Faulkner. She's good with the ball at her feet. Heyman. A few step overs, the crowd appreciated. Nilski to Hughes. Taylor Young now, can she accelerate? Well, she chooses to cut back on Bowler, who dives in, but thankfully for both parties there, misses everyone. She does recover the ball. Hits it long to Barbieri, who would have been well offside. Well, we're seeing a double substitution for Adelaide and a debut for Danish Hannah Holgersen. She's a forward from AGF in Denmark, played with Jenna McCormick over there. We're also seeing the introduction of Fiona Wirtz, last season's Julie Dolan medalist and Golden Boot winner. Only one goal so far this season. Does she have the magic in her boots today? Be interesting to see the changes for Adelaide, considering both players on the pitch are ostensibly forwards. And Hodgson and Haywood, not so much. Wirtz in her first action trying to keep the ball in, doesn't succeed. Canberra United will make a substitution of their own. Chloe Middleton coming on to midfield in place of Laura Hughes. Her fifth appearance this season, all off the bench. And she is certainly a vital cog of this Canberra side this season. Canberra, long ball, Heyman. Middleton straight into the action. A touch for Jale. Go back to Middleton. A distinctive green bow in her hair, Chloe Middleton. Ball cleared long for Adelaide. Ma does well. Milivojevic. Hayley Taylor Young in a battle with Wirtz now. Fiona Wirtz unable to win the ball. The second time this season that Fiona Wirtz has been introduced off the bench. It's remarkable to think at the start of the season that her starting place would even be questioned in this team. But now Canberra, Middleton's won the ball. He's looking for Heyman, a crucial interception from McCormick. Now Jale looking for the long diagonal. Flannery on the ball. She's got options in the middle. Squares it. Too close to Annalie Grove. So we see a replay of that chance in the picture-in-picture. We've seen that long diagonal a few times today. for Canberra. In fact, it was a similar ball that led to Michelle Heyman's second goal, that incredible diving header in the first half. Flannery delivering on a plate for her captain. Adelaide win the ball back. Waldus will look to switch play, long diagonal of their own, looking for Holgersen. But the ball finds its way off the pitch. A late signing, Hannah Holgersen, her A-League debut today. We'll see what she can produce. The signing, of course, to replace the likes of Amelia Murray, who's out on young Matilda's duty, and also Chelsea Dauber, who's been recalled from her loan by Chicago Red Stars in the NWSL. She'll be off playing in Sweden. Of course, if the scores stay as they are at the moment, Canberra United, well, they'll remain fifth as the ball is crossed in. And Holgersen, well, colliding quite heavily with Keely Richards. Neither player really in the wrong, both going for the ball. And unfortunately, both have come out of that challenge worse for wear. Well, Holgersen has only been on the pitch for mere minutes and unfortunately has copped some heavy contact on that right foot in the collision with Richards. We'll hope that she's okay, but as it stands, Canberra fifth on the ladder but equal on points with Melbourne Victory in the same amount of games played. Melbourne Victory with a bye this week. So I'm sure that Victory fans and players will be keenly watching this one. As we see that collision again. Richards just copping one on the arm, and Holgersen, well, it looks like her right knee may have been the victim of that collision. We hope that she's okay, the Dane. Well, the good news is that she is being lifted to her feet, but unfortunately in tears. We'll have a look at the goals that have been scored so far in this game. Firstly, a penalty to Grace Maher. And then Michelle Heyman, true poacher's goal. That one after a shot from Milivojevic. Adelaide back in the game. A wonderful goal from Katie Bowler, her first in the Liberty A-League. And then a long diagonal across to Flannery. And she puts the ball on a plate for a diving header from Heyman. Adelaide, though, hit back again. Mushka Waldus with the header from the free kick. Well, that is devastating for Hannah Holgersen, mere moments after her debut for Adelaide. She is unfortunately leaving the pitch. Zoe Tolland, the 20-year-old from Adelaide City, will be replacing her. Her fourth appearance in the A-League. And well, there's been somewhat of a collision here. Now Nikki Flannery has an opportunity, and just over the crossbar. Well, there's been a few times this game where Canberra have seemingly had the field open up for them and they've not been able to put those chances away. Flannery not hitting the target, after being presented with a gift from the Adelaide defence. And given the state of this game and how dangerous Adelaide have looked, it could be something that they regret here, Canberra. Faulkner clears. Wu does well. Lavojevic. Out wide, Jale. Heyman. Looking for Jale again with too much juice on that pass. McCormick. Adelaide playing out from the back. Nice ball through. Chasing it down is Barbieri, but Faulkner clears. And we'll have a look at this opportunity for Flannery. A long ball from Keely Richards, and then, well, Tollins, who just came on the pitch, and Waldis just collided, meaning that Nikki Flannery had an open goal and only the keeper to beat. And she's missed the target. And that could have been real calamity areas for Adelaide. Well, as we approach the final 15 minutes of this game, no goals in the second half just yet. And Canberra United, well, every time this season that Michelle Heyman has scored, they have picked up the 3 points. So historically this season, they would be feeling very confident, but Adelaide are knocking on the door, and you can see another turnover in possession high up the pitch. An opportunity now for Barbieri, who shoots on the turn. And Richards collects. Well, it would have been called for offside. That is an example of the danger that Adelaide still pose. Looks like their goal scoring doom from earlier in the season may be slightly relaxing, but well, after conceding 3 goals today, it might be more. Michelle Heyman. Michelle Heyman gets a hat trick. She points to the sky. She is simply undeniable in this competition. Canberra United go 2 goals to the good again. And it is through the all-time leading goal scorer, Michelle Heyman. And when Michelle Heyman gets the ball in that position, you simply know she's going to score. There are not enough words in the English language to describe Michelle Heyman at the moment. That puts her top of the Golden Boot race. A few weeks ago, well, we thought that Hannah Keane was done and dusted at the top of that list, but now she has been overtaken by a legend of the game. And I'll tell you what, there might be some Australian head coaches watching this game and wondering. Oh, Canberra, they'll feel a lot more confident now with the 2-goal lead restored. And still a lot of work to do in the final moments of this one. Negos Popovic telling his players to get close and take a chance from the free kick. It is Adelaide who do come away with it, although intercepted by Jale. Jale attempted to find Heyman. Ball cleared by Hodgson. Down the line, Wirtz to Holmes. Holmes does well, wins a free kick. A handball conceded by Canberra. Well, Adelaide, they have not gone away in this game. Tollins off the bench. Does really well to get it to Westland. Tollins on the ball again. Westland trying to find a way through. And Flannery is in there, as well as Maher, and Canberra win the goal kick, rather. Well, we are witnessing greatness today on our screens, and the goals that Michelle Heyman has scored today, a poacher's goal, a diving header, and then 1v1, Michelle Heyman with the ball at her feet in that situation. You just know the net will ripple. Very popular figure with this home crowd. So Canberra have made a substitution. It's Ellen Getz from Queensland who's come onto the pitch, and Nikki Flannery has made way. Wu clears the ball away. Long ball looking for Heyman. Middleton doing well. Jale. It's interesting to see Ellen Getz. Looks like she's occupying that left winger position. She was signed as a forward from Queensland, was part of the QAS program up there, but has been largely playing as a centre back for Canberra, so is back playing in her more natural position for the final 10 minutes of this one. Taylor Young, Middleton, attempted all pass, didn't quite work out, and Adelaide with the ball once more. Wu does well, wins the ball, and it is Get on the ball now. Although a misplaced pass, Heyman will chase it down against Hodgson. A foul against Heyman for her troubles. Emily Hodgson doing very well. You can see Wu's just done really well to win the ball off Holmes. What was it? Battle of strength, nothing in it from the referee. Holmes was the one who lost out. Aldous launching it forward, a mistake from Faulkner. That travels harmlessly to Richards. Maher up the line. Miscue from McCormick. Get trying to win the ball back. Barbieri looking for Isabel Hodgson, the captain. But Ilioski will take the throw. Middleton now in some space. Milivojevic. Now through the middle, Chloe Middleton, is she onside? Grove comes out and clears well. Cleared with the required distance. But Canberra weren't able to take advantage of her distance from her line. Richards happy to let Adelaide run at her there. Very composed performance from the 28-year-old today. Sasaki through the middle, Holmes, Zoe Tolland. Down the line, Ilioski's missed it, and Isabel Hodgson with an opportunity. Just wasn't able to get it under control. Those are the moments that Adelaide will need to take if they are to wrest anything from this game. Well, Adelaide's problems coming into this game were largely goal scoring, but today it's their defense that has let them down. Four goals conceded against this Canberra side, who are looking so dangerous at the moment. This is really the form side of the competition at the moment, at least out of the top four anyway. They're only three goals now behind Melbourne Victory and behind that fourth spot. Diagonal ball claimed by Richards. Richards, Middleton. Looked really good since coming on, to be fair, Chloe Middleton. Ellen gets in a battle against two Adelaide players and loses out. Dylan Holmes looking for Fiona Wirtz, who goes to ground and claims off a penalty, but waved away by Isabella Libri. Now Wu. Well, a bit of a miscue from Annalie Grove, and Ellen Getz now on the ball. Heyman opted not to go herself in the moment. The ball skewed just far enough away from her that she wasn't able to turn and shoot. And Keely Richards, well, shows her how it's done. Up the other end, clears for distance. Adelaide driving forward once more, gets intercepts. Well, Canberra fans and fans of the league alike, mark your calendars, Saturday, 18th of March at McKellar Park. Canberra take on Melbourne Victory, the team that they are now equal on points with for that fourth spot. That could be crucial to determining what the makeup of the final series is this season. Perth as well, of course, in a run of their own, looking very good at the moment themselves. So we could be in for a three-way race for that fourth spot if Perth win their remaining games. In fact, they'll take that fourth spot ahead of both Canberra or Victory. So interesting times in the dub at the moment. And of course, the joys of the extended season, that we can see this play out. Teams that may not have had the best starts have the opportunity to come back into the league and have a run at the championship race. McCormick out wide. Played in for Barbieri. Jarlay tracking the runner. No called back for offside. We will see the final substitution for Canberra. The hat-trick woman, Michelle Heyman, makes way, and it's Grace Taranto who will come on the park for her third appearance of the season. Wonderful performance from the veteran. And it is 19-year-old Taranto who will replace her. Grace Taranto played her NPL football for South Melbourne alongside Holly Murray. In fact, who started this game, was substituted out at halftime. A defender or midfielder, Taranto. Here come Adelaide, last chance saloon here for the Reds. Ball in, header, post. And Richards claims, so close for Adelaide United. Dylan Holmes cannot hide her disappointment. This was really good work from the captain, Isabel Hodgson. Put it on a platter for Holmes. And Richards was rooted to the spot. But the ball refused to go in. It was scrambled away. Well, the free kick to be retaken here. Barbieri standing over it. Can Adelaide find a way back into this match? Can they wrestle a point from this fixture? Ready for the free kick. Awaiting the referee's word. Vieri delivers. And high, never challenging Keely Richards that time. And to the astonishment of the crowd, there are 7 minutes of stoppages in the second half, so still plenty of time for Adelaide. If they can keep getting these opportunities, although Canberra certainly in the ascendancy as it stands. Middleton chasing it down, Dylan Holmes. Ball up the line, Grace Maher. And it looked for a moment like Westland might be able to nip in ahead of Grace Maher. It's happened several times throughout the game where Maher's let it run to the goalkeeper. Hasn't cost Canberra, but maybe something for the training ground. Zoe Tolland. Now, unless the remarkable happens, and Adelaide managed to find a way to score 3 goals in stoppage time, this will be their 9th game without a win in this competition. And for a team who finished 3rd last season, were tipped for great things this time around. It is a disappointment the way that 2023 has gone so far. And as they look to have solved one problem, which is goals, scoring 4 in the last 2 games, they're conceding thick and fast instead. A lot of problems for coach Adrian Stenser to resolve. But it is Isabel Hodgson who's in some space here. If she can find a teammate. And Keely Richards out smartly. A very tidy game from Keely Richards in the absence of Chloe Lincoln with that young Matilda squad. And now Ellen Getz. In some space, the youngster, ball played through Grace Taranto almost finding herself on the end of that. The substitute was called back for offside. And wouldn't that have been a story if the South Melbourne youngster had managed to get on the end of that. Wu does well, intercepted by Westland. Null no here, Adelaide, still 4 minutes of time to get back into this game. Waldis blocked away. Ball up the line to Wu. He's only got McCormick to beat. Wu does really well. Can she finish now? Oh, McCormick gets back in time. And it's cleared. Chengshu Wu. Fantastic energy from the halftime substitute. She's looked really good in that midfield for Canberra. And Jenna McCormick on that occasion just does just enough to put her off her effort. Last chance saloon now for Adelaide. Lovely turn from Dylan Holmes. And now in some space is Hodgson, but out smartly again is Keely Richards. Well, if you're a stat snuffy, the XG for this game for Canberra United is 4.58, which is actually the highest of any game this season for any one team. So it's been an attacking clinic from Canberra United today. Adelaide, meanwhile, 0.98 in the same column. So again, it's not necessarily been that they've been extremely clinical, Canberra. It's that they've created a mountain of chances. And Adelaide simply have not been able to keep them all out. They've looked irrepressible, Canberra, and they've been a joy to watch this afternoon. McCormick. Up the line, Barbieri back to McCormick. Time running out for Adelaide. McCormick again, Middleton applying the pressure. Sasaki, ball through to Hodgson. But Richards again. She's been fantastic, really, the Canberra keeper today. Only a third appearance of the season. It's not necessarily the flashy saves, but she's been able to smother those opportunities so often. You talk about things like XG as a calculation of a shot percentage chance, and well, the reason Adelaide's is so low is probably because Richards has been able to smother the opportunity before they arise. You can see confirmation of that stat on your screen. Doesn't tell everything, but it does tell you what an attacking threat Canberra United have been. Ball forward. You can hear the Canberra crowd now counting down. They want that victory. They want that 3 points. And it is full time at MacKellar Park. A flurry of goals in the first half, and a hat-trick to Michelle Heyman means that at full-time, Canberra United go equal fourth with Melbourne Victory in fourth place on the ladder. It is Canberra United 4, Adelaide United 2.
When Melbourne Victory are our visitors in the match presented by the University of Canberra.
And we'll have a look at the final stats of what has been an enthralling afternoon in the nation's capital. You can see Canberra having the better, more shots on target, more corners. They've been just the better side today, the more attacking threat. And while Adelaide will have plenty of positives to take from the game, unfortunately, it is another game without a win in 2023. We'll leave you here with celebration shots from McKellar Park in the hat-trick hero, Michelle Heyman. It is Canberra United 4, Adelaide United 2.
Yeah, we look nice, future looking nice, we don't need to tell them twice.
Here comes the future.
Yeah, we look nice, future looking real nice, we don't need to tell them twice.
Here comes the future.